Let's conclude. True Christian discipleship must result in the disciple being able to live the life of Christ or have the life of Christ lived through him or her. The necessity of the life of Christ lived through us is thus accomplished when we have the divine nature, and through the word of God and the deeds of the Holy Spirit, we can express that nature in our daily lives as we interact with other people. God never intended that we will be isolated from the world. In John 17, 15 and 16, John 17, 15 and 16, the Lord just said, I do not pray that you should take them out of the world, but that you should keep them from the evil one. They are not of the world, just as I am not of the world. He never prayed that we should be taken out of the world, but that we should be protected in the world. Do you understand? So let us stop trying to isolate ourselves. That was the mistake of Israel of old. They tried to isolate themselves. In the presence of isolation, they were imbibing the idols of other people, of other nations, until finally God had to send them into exile. Do you know that people knew more of God when Israel went into exile than when Israel was in their land? Because in exile, Daniel had to show himself. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, Nehemiah, Ezra, and so many others. It was in exile that they knew God. 200 years before Christ came, the then Bible, the Old Testament, the Torah, the Psalms and the prophets and everything had been translated into Greek by the Greeks. They had known God, but how? By exile. God does not want you to go on exile for him to be known. Go and start telling people about God. Show by your lifestyle who God is. And when you have an opportunity to minister to people, minister based on the fact that you are ministering Christ. You are ministering to Christ. It is God's intention to ensure that the knowledge of him spreads throughout the world. Thus, the believer in Christ, who has allowed the Holy Spirit to transform him or her into the image of Christ, can thus become the heart and hands of God in a dark, sinful world, manifesting the goodness, forgiveness, and love of God to countless numbers of people all over the world. The Christian is not supposed to be cursing a government, a governor or president. We are to pray for them. There was a story I read of a man who heard that somebody told him that prayer works. And the guy said he doesn't believe it. So they decided to have a bet, $50. So the guy who said prayer works told the guy who said prayer does not work that why don't you take a country in the world and pray for that country consistently for 30 days and let us see what will happen. And he began to pray. Every day he picked the nation of Kenya and was praying for Kenya every day. Towards the end of the 30 days, he hadn't finished 30 days, though, he was invited to a dinner function. When he got to this dinner function, a lady sat next to him. By the time they introduced them, the lady happened to be a missionary in Kenya who was doing some work to get some Kenyans rehabilitated. She needed to build a hospital. The guy said when he sat next to this woman and heard that the woman's work is in Kenya, he said, I saw $50 flying out of my pocket. But he said, no problem, that indeed he agrees that prayer works. And what did he do? He told the lady that, don't worry, I will support this work. He single-handedly got around his friends to raise the money to build that hospital in Kenya. When they were going to dedicate the hospital, they invited him, he flew down to Kenya for the opening of the hospital. The lady announced to the people who came, including the president of Kenya, that this is the man who single-handedly raised the money to build this hospital. The president of Kenya said, no way, this man, I must show you Nairobi. He took the man inside his car, presidential car, to show him Nairobi. And he was showing him this, showing him that, showing him this. Finally, he got to a place. The man said to the president, you didn't tell me what is here. He said, no, it's a prison house. I keep my I keep all my political enemies in that place. And the man said to the president, Mr. President, the word of God says we should bless our enemies and not curse them. You cannot incarcerate your enemies. You have to set them free. For the sake of Christ, you need to set them free. And the discussion finished, and the man went home. 6 months, 2 or 3 months after that meeting, he got a call from State Department in the U.S., more like what we call, I don't know how, we don't have the equivalent in Nigeria here. Would have said Foreign Affairs Ministry, but it's more than the Foreign Affairs Ministry. It's actually the major arm of government in America. State Department called him and said, are you so-and-so? He said, yes. Were you in Kenya at so-and-so time? And he said, yes. Did you have a meeting, a discussion with the Kenyan president? He said, yes. He said, what did you tell him? He said, why? He said, we've been trying to release political prisoners for years. The man refused. The man released them last month and said that he met with an American, mentioned your name, and that you told him something. What did you tell him? He said, I told him that it is wrong to incarcerate your enemies. They said, no, you couldn't have said that. We have told him more than... What do you think was working there? He was a representative of Christ. Is it any wonder that Kenya has all the attention? That a Kenyan born was America's president? One man prayed for 30 days for a nation called Kenya. Do we pray for our country? No. We curse. Just open to social media. That's when you... They will say something evil about Nigeria and put a name, Donald Trump. Donald Trump doesn't... He doesn't have time to be talking about Nigeria. Wicked human beings. And when you check them, they are Christians. Just because you don't like the man who is the president. When your brother was the president, a Christian, look at all the thefts that we heard of. But no, we hate this country. We will talk against the country. Why can't we pray for Nigeria and see things happen? But no, we will not. We'll rather come to church and pray for our business. For 10 hours, we want to pray for our business. Pray for your country. The Bible says, pray for the peace of the country where you are. If that country has peace, you will have peace. How do you want to isolate your own business in a country that does not have peace, in a corrupt country? You will enter that same corruption. But when you pray for your country and you want corruption removed from your country, you cannot be a partaker of it in any shape or form. May the Lord help us. And this is where the acts become significant. Do you see how that the man's act was significant now? He used the resource of prayer, and God began to, and as God was leading him and taking him into one place or the other, he continued to elevate the name of Christ. Christian discipleship is thus not an academic discipline, culminating and terminating in a certificate. Rather, it is the channel or means through which the nature of Christ is worked in the disciple, which then allows God through the Holy Spirit to manifest his grace upon all of mankind as disciples interact with them, working miracles where necessary, preaching where it is needed, and teaching as is appropriate. Luke chapter 4, from verse 16 to 21. This was the Lord Jesus. So he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. And he was handed the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord." Then he closed the book and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all who were in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." And I say to you, today, this same scripture is fulfilled in your hearing. Amen. The gospel is to be preached to the poor. Heal the sick. Deliver those who are demon possessed. Don't possess them yourself. Set them free. Let them be free indeed. If the Son shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. Allow Christ to set them free. You are not the one who will set them free. Suddenly, you now become the one who is the deliverer. You must come next week. We have to pray another special prayer next week. Then two weeks from now, when you are coming, you bring palm oil, you bring pepper, and you make sure that you bring ground tomatoes. Who does not know that that man wants to cook stew? Then 2 weeks from now, he says, the mammy water that's holding is very strong. When you come, you bring croaker, very strong brick croaker, at least three or four. He's telling you that I did not have fish in that stew that you cook. And this time around, come again with ground tomatoes and pepper. Make sure that you put onions and olive oil. Don't go and buy yamayama oil in the market. Make sure it is pure virgin olive oil. He wants to cook stew. You are now his meal ticket, and you don't know. Every time you are going, you say you are doing deliverance. In Acts chapter 10, verse 38, the Bible says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. That was what Christ was doing. That's what he expects us to do. Now that we are representing, now that he's in us, what should we be doing? Going about doing good, healing all that are oppressed of the devil. God is with you. But what are we doing? Going about gossiping. Going about telling lies. Going about being deceitful. Going about coming up with plans that don't go anywhere. And causing more and more people to enter into more and more bondage. Hence, the Lord Jesus asserted, and I'm quoting John chapter 9, verse 4 to 5, the Amplified Version. We, if you read the King James, it says I. But I looked at all the translations, they all said we. So he wasn't really talking about himself. He was saying those of us who are children of God say, we must walk the works of him who sent me and be busy with his business while it is daylight. Night is coming on when no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the world's light. You are the light of the world. There is work to be done. Many things that we are running after are unnecessary. I'm telling you the truth. When you are doing what God wants you to do, God is taking care of your needs. Not your wants, not your desires, not your extravagant desires, but everything you need. If what you need is a meal, you will get a meal that day. Tomorrow you get a meal. You may not have a pantry that is full, but are you hungry? You'll be fed. You can't starve. The Bible says, even in a famine, the righteous does not have any lack. Don't we read the Bible? Then we allow some men to come and tell us abundance in recession. If you want abundance in recession, you have to sow. They don't have. So they ask you to sow so that they can have, that God will give you. You should have told them, Oga, you, the way you go and sow in a ministry, let God also give you. Do the work of God and God will meet you at the point of need. Brethren, there's work to be done. But it can only be acceptably done when we have been properly discipled and can practically demonstrate the divine nature in our daily interaction with other people without being enticed by the lure of sin and the world or offended by the entrapment of Satan's wiles. Remember, I told you the story of two brothers that were prayer warriors together. They were praying together, prayer partners. And the day Satan wanted to scatter them, what did he do? He allowed the proud one to be promoted and retained the, what's the one now? No, that one's not humble. The one with envy, he made him to remain where he was. So out of envy, he was envying his prayer partner that was now promoted. The prayer partner was proud. Because those things were not removed, Satan used it against them. And that was the end of the prayer meeting. Do you know how many of you have left churches? Because you will not deal with the flesh in you. You will blame other people, but yourself. Then you get away and you go to this church. It's the same thing. You are the same person now. You haven't changed. The churches are not going to change for you. That is why you will continue to have the problems anywhere you go. It doesn't matter anywhere you go to. You will still have it. So the sooner you allow the Holy Spirit to do the work in you, the better. Indeed, before the acts, there must first be a becoming like Christ. And before the manifestation of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, there must first be the producing of the fruit of the Spirit. May the Lord help us.